It's not just about being a DJ.
It's funny because I always knew Bob Andy was special, you know? Mm-hmm. Yeah, something about his songs, them, and how he used to... The words he used to use and the clever songwriting. Bob Andy stood out to me as young, when I was young. You know? Yeah, Bob Andy was one, and I really loved John Holt as well. And as a youngster, I knew the album was special. The Thousand Rocks album, you know, it's a special album. And yeah, so that's the word that I was introduced to, you know? Elroy Woodson and those artists there. But yeah, I love all genres, you know. I really love soul music as well. Mm-hmm. You know, yeah, man, we're a music lover. All together.
I'll tell you what, the phone lines are starting to blow up now.
Big up the listeners.
You know, the listeners, I just want to send a big, massive dedication going out to Valerie down there in Manchester. Another one going out to Merle, Wendy up there in Norwood, Yvonne down there in Mottingham. Big up, massive dedication going out to my cousin Howard down there in North London, alongside Monique. Also going out to Stephen and Dawn. Glad to know you tuned in. Easy Lady Scorpion, Lady Minx out there, Lady Irie, Hot Chocolate, Short Man, Carlotta out there, Natalie and Jackie. Easy yourself, Natalie. It's your fault. You know, listen. Another one going out to Terence and also Pauline. Out there across the line in Capital. So,
big up everyone, yeah, man.
Yeah, the calls are flying in.
Sitting with us, yeah.
Now, someone asked me to play this tune here. Mm-hmm. Another one of your tunes. I'm not even going to say what it is.
Okay.
But listen to it, because I'm going to play the instrumental after for you to sing on this one as well.
For real?
Yes. All right?
All right.
All right. We're going to kick it off like this. Easy Hillary from the Beeline Crew.
Murder. Sure. Deadly. Ha!
Smooth. Yeah. Alright.
Rebel, this a bad girl, D.I. Ready for whatever Patrick know, I'm in a shy. Yo, this is the girl, Daniel D.I., the rebel, representing for my man, Patrick Isaacs, on the Lightning Radio. You know, it's not normal, right? Everything turn over. Ouch.
Okay, we're gonna head you over to Chris. Instrumental style, you're gonna go live, eh?
Everything right. I do.
Jeez.
Look at this. I want you by my side. Knowing how I love you, I'll make you my bride.
Jeez.
The way I want love you, girl, I'm going to give you good, good loving. Yes, good, good loving.
All right.
The kind of love it's gonna be. Yes. It will be exclusively for you, my baby. Knowing how I love you, knowing how I need, I'm going to give. Gonna give you some good, some good, good love. Oh yeah, the love I'm gonna give. I know you don't deserve the kind of feeling it's gonna be, yes. But now I feel like I'm at home, on my own, on my own. Still I'm gonna give you some good, good loving, some good, good hugging, yes, some good, good kissing, and then some good, good. Oh, big up Patrick Isaac. The music nice, the music sweet. Make me wanna dance and move my feet.
Now, she's there and I can just go and check her at any time. And every day, me and I end up play fight, man. What I don't, is it? You know?
Okay.
Yeah, man, I'm the wash belly, so, you know, extra close.
Okay, I'm gonna play that tune again because you're going wild. I tell you.
Instrumental.
See, I feel like I want to write a song, so I'm gonna sing something new, something.
Yo.
Let's see if I can make up a song right now for the listeners.
Jeez.
Big up all the ladies. We're never gonna diss ya. I'm the champion. I'm the number one. They say my voice is so strong. I'm the ooh. You.
Look.
The rhythm's so sweet and the rhythm's so nice. Yes, the rhythm on us cold like ice. I said the rhythm so sweet and the rhythm so smooth. We're gonna win while they're gonna lose. Said the rhythm so yes, 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 yes. Big up BMW. Oh, yes, Winston, the Dan said we are the champion number one. The only one, only.
Yo, this is all right, I tune it up.
I said the song is gonna be a song you never heard before. Jeez. I said the dancing, my dancing feet. All the lightning listeners, all the lightning listeners. Oh, whoa, whoa. Yes, yes, yes. Good, good love, good, good hugging, and good, good kiss, good kiss.
Yes, indeed. You want to say, look at that.
Good. There you go.
Oh, yeah,
me.
Directing the line. You still can't. Corona mashup everything.
So, what have you been up to in this lockdown?
So, the lockdown has been kind of good to me because I've managed to be at home with my family, you know, and my man is always moving around, always flying around, and, you know, I always tend to see me in their yard, you know, see my yard more time than I see in England, I think. So, yeah, it's been a time where I can just hold the ones at home with my youth, get me? And I have two young youths now.
I was just going to say, when you're talking about you, I didn't even know you had any children.
Yeah, I've got four children now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got
four children, yeah.
Okay.
Four children alone.
So what's their ages?
16, 12, 2 and 1.
Okay.
And have them in one nest as well. I know it's that part there. People think that's some scatter. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but I'm saying, yeah. So, you know, I have 2-year-old and a 1-year-old, and the big ones help with them. So yeah. It's nice to be at home and just be there with them instead of FaceTime, you know? And just hold, yeah, just show them, you know, certain things I want to show them daily that I can just implement now, and especially with these younger ones here. So, yeah, I'm just enjoying life, you know? Corona has given us a chance to bond back with our ones and our family.
Yeah.
And maybe, you know, we're going to work every day, or we're going, you know, studio or flying out and these things, and we can just be at home now and connect again.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, I've been doing that.
And it's nice to know that you're actually a family man, because you know, a lot of artists out there, you know, they have a lot of children. Some of them they're family orientated, looks after their kids. But yeah, it's nice to know that, well, you know, you're focusing on your children as well.
Yeah, I mean that is the what's the word now? That, because I'm a wash belly. That is what I gained from being a washbelly. I was able to watch and learn the mistakes of my brothers, you know, and see how, okay, that was okay, that's not my situation. So I came and said, you know what? I'm gonna live my life this way. You know, it was a conscious decision from me, from young.
Yeah.
I decided, not that, I'm not saying that, I mean, life doesn't always go how you expect it, so, you know, there might be a case where you do have a different life after a while, but, you know, I kind of planned this, you know what I mean? So, yeah, man. Yeah, so, yeah, man, glad to just be at home with them and his vibes and show them love and be a father.
Okay, well, you know, moving on to your, with regards to your career, are you signed to any major record labels?
Yeah, so I'm signed to a record label called Ghetto Youths International, which is run by Stephen Marley and Damien Marley.
Okay.
So they signed me right after the end of time, they signed me like probably like a week after that song. Mm-hmm. You know, so I've been signed to that label and it's great. And yeah, you asked me why I'm doing Corona. So I released a song called Still Go A Dance, and I was in Jamaica when it released. Mm-hmm. And it started to take off in Jamaica when I was there. Mm-hmm. And I was performing on stage shows, performing the song that's doing well, but then Corona happened and it just changed the whole dynamics. Mm-hmm. You know, so that was what we released in January from the record label. And yeah, so I'm signed to the label and everything's going great. That doesn't mean I'm not working with other producers though.
Yeah,
so I'm allowed to voice with other producers and use those songs on our album. You understand? So I can voice for a different producer and use those songs, even though I'm a signed artist to this label here.
So you can record for other artists.
For other producers.
Other producers. Yeah. But
as long as we have, you know, I have the ability to use a song on our album.
On your album.
Yeah, on the Ghetto Youth International album.
Right, from the Mali. Yeah. Okay. So, regards to the Malis. So was end of time was that to do with the Malis?
Yeah, so let me just put this story quick now. So my father passed away, 2008, right?
Yes.
I went to Jamaica to bury him with my family. I decided I'm going to stay in Jamaica.
Yeah.
My family came back to England. My mom, everyone came back to England. Mm-hmm. And I stayed in Jamaica and said, you know what? I'm doing music now. I don't care how, but I'm getting my foot in the door to music. And I was there for a few months. Well, after a while, someone said to me, yo, are Steve Marley for their own? Steve Marley for their own. They might have advised you. And he said, you know what? I know him, you know. You know what? Come, let's go there now. And we jumped in his car and drove to Bob Marley Museum.
Okay, so that was a friend of yours who said he knew Stephen Marley.
Yeah, so really he's my brother's friend because he's from Trenchtown, this person.
Okay.
And he's Stephen Marley's right-hand man. And he said, yo, he's always said to me from a few years before as well, so yo, that's Stephen Marley for Vice Ronan. He took me to Bob Marley Museum. And I'll never forget, Stephen Marley was sitting in a chair like a king. But 19 man there on him. This man I wore ganja, this man I wore mango. Sitting there and he said, yes, Arkansas, sit down, man. And I sat down and he said, you're singing it? I said, yeah. And then someone said, sing something for Stephen. And I sang a little intro for him. An intro went bad. I did it on a show and teared up the whole show.
Okay, now that intro that you sang, I want you to sing it now.
All right.
If you can remember.
I can. So, people, imagine this. I stayed backstage of a show in Jamaica. And I did this. I said, a few Gregory Isaacs, a few Dennis Brown, a few Delroy Wilson, Ken Booth, and John Holt. But tonight is the night that I'm feeling so nice. So I'm going to sing some Altanelli's tune. You sound rich, that's huh? The world plays a tear. The whole place are teared down. Mm-hmm. Teared down.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm singing Alton's tunes for you. I write this song. The place flattened. And I sang that to Stephen Marley anyway. And I said, yo, you're bad enough. I said, yo, come check me tomorrow. And I came and checked him the next day.
Mm-hmm.
And then Baby G, who was King Jammy's son.
Okay.
He walked in the studio. And... Sorry, he walked in the museum, because in the museum. And he played. He said, yo, Dad, I got a rhythm for you. And he played End of Time rhythm. So I'm just sitting on the sideline, you know, and he just played the rhythm. And Steve Martin said, yo, are you this bad? And then I sat there and I said to myself, it's the things you do that upsets me. And Steve Martin said, what? Sing that again. I was singing to myself, you know.
Okay.
So I sang it a bit louder upon the rhythm. And it fit. It's the things you do. I'm saying, yo, come studio. But I never had no more lines though. And prior to this, I never wrote no song before. So I was thinking, what studio? So we're driving to the studio now, a convoy of cars, you know, heading towards King Jammy's studio, you know. And I'm in the back thinking, wait,
what are you gonna do?
What am I gonna do? Yes, I'm with David, my brother-in-law.
Okay.
He's my manager in time. And I was thinking, what am I gonna do? Reached to the studio, about 19 men just staring at me like, all right, go on then, no? And I got a pen and paper and I got kind of stuck. That's why that line's in there from you make me happy. You see what I said? The others were untrue. Yeah. I didn't want to put that in there really, you know. I wanted the whole song to be original. But you know, I got stuck. I just put that line there in there to kind of help me. Then after that line out, I find back myself now. You know what I mean? And then the song was finished. Christopher Ellis featuring Stephen Marley. But hold on. Jacquio walked in the studio when the song was finished. And the song was playing on the speakers. And I said, no man, I feel up on this. No man, that song you're bad. Me, I feel up on this song. And I'm the biggest Cure fan, you know.
Yeah.
So I said to Baby G, who was the engineer, take off my last verse and put Cure up on the end. And he said to me, all right, then every the first though, go in there and introduce Cure. So go in there and say, listen, Jacquio. So I found the song here and said, listen, Jacquio. And then song, and then Cure put the cherry up on the top of the song. This is what I told her. Murder. End of time.
Murder. There you go. There you go. Live and direct it right here in the Lightning Studios. You heard it. From the man himself. He's telling you what's going on.
Smooth.
Everybody knows that I'm the king of town. Everybody knows this. Dum dum there. I'm lost that love, that love, that love. Before I said, God, man, and I close and I close and I close the door. And you say, try once more.
I feel the brokenness in me in this though.
When you turn and you walk through that door, it hurts me so now. Said it hurts me so. It hurts me so. Ooh. Listen to me. She didn't bat an eye. As I packed my bags to leave,
I thought what?
I thought she would start to cry. I stood on a roof and weep. I said, I know you're ready to come to rock steady. My ease. You've got to do this new dance now that you're ready. You've got to do it just like Uncle Alton now that you know this.
Yeah.
Hairs arise in the morning. I give your thanks and praise from so far.
Crazy,
he keeps some boys at bay. I've been made the greatest choice in my life that I know I won't regret. All the time is the greatest you will ever hear. He's always there wherever I go. The power I feel, that's how I know he's always there wherever I go.
Put up, selector.
East. Yeah, man. Niceness, that. Niceness, niceness, niceness.
That was 2008. Can you believe it?
Yeah.
2008. Mm-hmm.
2008.
That's
right.
That's 12
years ago.
Man.
Yeah.
That's
when.
That's how much time is flying.
When pops
can you believe it? It's a serious, serious thing. How much time is flying?
Well, that's what it comes to when it comes to, because you know what I noticed a lot of artists when it comes to them producing their tunes or when it comes out, you know, some of the artists they forget because it could be many, many years.
Yeah, right.
You know.
Yeah. I know.
So
I feel like I feel like one thing about me though in my career.
The chain that binds me.
Man, button up. Yeah, man.
Pitching and pitching one more time, third time around. Remember, live and direct in the Lightning Studios, Christopher Ellis, son of the legendary Alton Ellis. We're going on till 9 o'clock, 1 hour extension.
Stay with us, stay with us. I tell you.
Up at 9 till 11, DJ Colonel. Vibes flowing right now, may I tell you.
Singing it all, yes. Whoa! Big up the listeners, Dead Right P, big up everybody in tune. Christopher Ed is speaking. Yeah.
Sing it, Chris. One.
Oh, write something smooth. What I'm gonna write on this pretty little tune. Scabina.
Whoa!
Mr. Scabina. Every night I sing this, every night I sing this. Scabina. Said that if you want me, oh baby, call me Scabina. Senorita. Well,
oh.
Right. Your love, your arms, your charms, Scabina. Señor, love your
army.
Señorita. Oh, brother. I said, oh, can you take it down? And can you slowly fade it down? Can you slowly fade it down? Mr. Scabina.
Yeah, man.
Then put out the artwork for like maybe like 5-6 days,
mm-hmm.
So people can talk like, yeah, wait, Chris, what are you talking about? Because the song's called Only Want You Naked. Yeah, this song's called Only Want You Naked. So people are like, wait, oh, Chris, what, wait, some slackness team done. You know, but it's a trick. Listen, nice piece of song.
listening to lightningradio.net. Patrick Claddock from the Studio One crew.
They come with their expensive cars and fancy diamonds. Approach you with their flashy talk and words to make you think.
Jeez.
When I don't own hardly anything, so I don't know how I'm gonna win. I'm hoping you can see the signs, so open up your eyes. I'm hoping you're not tempted by their fabricated lines. When I don't own hardly anything, I will surely give you feelings that you've never ever known. And they might try to woo you with design, but I know they don't have your future on their mind. Yeah. Amazing you, I love you, never let you go. The things I do are for you, I just hope you know.
I feel bad that I don't know their name right now. But it was their first production.
Okay.
And when they played the rhythm to me, I loved it straight away. I said, yo, can I write about now? I'm gonna go black on black, you know what I mean? And I wanted to, yeah, something different, you know. I purposely didn't go in a love zone, you know, in a love world. I wanted to speak about that, you know what I'm saying? So I said, there is so much to cure. Both the rich and the poor, bring the peace, not the war. Keep us safe and secure. These lives matter for sure. That's been said before. Because the last killing, them said Black Lives Matter.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to put the neatly in there. I don't want to say Black Lives Matter.
Yeah.
That would be ordinary writing. I'm going to twist it. These lives, everyone knows already what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
These lives matter for sure. That's been said before. You know? Black on black. Sweet piece of tune, man. And, you know, this tune needs to be released like digitally because it came out on 7-inch only.
Okay.
2,000 copies and said, gone.
I got it.
Yeah, mad. You have it. Murder. So yeah, I'm gonna put these things on like Spotify and places. You know what I mean?
Mm.
So upon the album, I think these songs there should definitely be on the album.
Yes.
You know, because they're strong songs.
Especially like what's happening right now. You know, it's like if you done it over a year ago, it's like you're looking into the future.
Yeah, man. This was. Right, 2018, in fact.
You see what I mean?
Imagine that.
Mm-hmm.
2018, but yeah, man, it's some. Yo, sweet piece of tune, man. Yes, are you black? Black on black, baby. Black until you black, you
Selector, come now.
Black on black, yeah, black for sure. Black on black, yeah, and black some more. Black on black, yeah, black for sure. I see you black on black, yeah, and black some more.
Easy, Jack, out there, stop new in
terms. You're the fighting for. Oh.
He's the Mama June.
I'm loving you, hey, I love you. Yo, I love her as my baby, love her as my woman. Loving you so crazy, girl, you're a winner.
Bad. Live and direct in the Lightning Studios. Remember, we're Christopher Ellis live
artist. I mean, DJs and selectors. I'm talking to all selectors and DJs. So listen keenly.
Pitching one more time, live and direct in the studios with Christopher Ellis in the Lightning Studios. What should I tell you?
Jeez, Dada!
Chumbad!
Bless up, man.
We're going to talk about this tune after how this came about. Anyway, Chris, over to you!
Jeez!
It's when I get music
played. Jeez!
Watch the way the dance all changed. Hey, it's when I get music play. Watch the way the dance all change. Yet we still go our dancing way. Said we not cause no trouble. I know this, we had this. We really love how you juggle. But there's a sound that we miss. We've got most ground covered. But we want to reminisce about the long time days. Yes, we want it from Venice.
Now listen, may I please try and pitch this one more time, right? Because as Chris said, you know, it goes out to all the DJs, them, and who else, Chris?
Selectors, man, and DJs.
Yes.
Directly, the song made for them.
May I tell you?
You know what I mean?
You have to listen to the lyrics, Easy, Jackie up there in the Stunt Newington side of town, glad to have you on board, you know? And as Chris said, you know, you've got to listen to the lyrics.
Please.
On this tune. Listen. Robert Allen used to say, you know, the tune but tell the police I look free.
Yeah.
I tell you.
Yo, see if you heard this. Let me hear this. Feel more of this. One, two, three.
Shirley down there in the Nottingham side of town. Glad to have you on board, Ian is from the Charlie's Angels crew.
This one, I get music played.
He's at the Peterborough Massive. He's at Lexus and Fritz having their Sunday dinner, ain't done.
This one reggae music play. What a way the dance all changed. Yet we still go by dancing way. Huh. Selector, pick up yourself. How we are enjoying the night. Me and my whole crew run out. We are going to hold our mind. Let me not dry out.
This is Sonia and also Rhea.
Pull up there, pull up. Ewa, ewa. You feel like... Hold on, let us stop.
Original sample.
Let us stop the ominous ones.
You feel like, say, that line they go over enough people's head, you know? We want air cool and deadly. You go dance with my girl, but if we call for your Gregory, it's one man against the world.
Your selectors, you know what I'm going to listen. But that line will go over people's head, you know. The Gregory have a song name, One Man Against the World.
Yes.
You know what I mean? So I'm just use it in, because remember I'm saying that it's me alone crying for these songs.
Yes.
So I'm me against the world, I say, yo, what, play the Ken Book then, play it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we'll just use it back in this as a metaphor.
Because at the end of the day, I mean, what you're saying with regards to this song, you know, some of the DJs out there, it's like they're playing for themselves.
Yeah, it is. And you know, the thing is, yeah, I didn't want to sound like, I didn't want to sound grumpy. So that's why in the end I say, yet we still go about the same way. You know, just to not sound grumpy, like when I just moan in a song. You know what I mean? And I feel like it's mainly in the dance hall where, you know, there's a space for Alton Ellis and for a Ken Booth and for a Delroy Wilson. You know, even in the early part, but it's like, I'm not hearing that again, you know? I'm hearing straight the thing. Mm. I love music, I love dancehall as well, you get me? I'm not gonna lie to you, me love the Alkaline them. Yeah, me love the Cartel them and Rare. But I feel like, let's not leave out the foundation man them.
Yeah.
That set the thing.
It's all about a mixture.
Yeah, man, you know, give them a good part in the first part of the dance. And see, this song was only written because I was saying this vocally. I was talking to Dom about this subject, you know, and after we spoke about it, you know, I got back playing the computer and I picked up the guitar.
Mm-hmm.
And I started singing that chorus over and over, and that's how the song was born, you know. So it's born from a conversation, but yeah, I never want to sound too grumpy, so, you know, still going down the same way.
Yeah. I'm gonna play it again. I'm gonna play it again, you know, and I think people are beginning to realize, you know, with regards to this song, what you actually mean.
Yeah, man.
You know, because, you know, it's a thing where we all go to dances, we all go to parties or whatever, but it's all about the mixture of music sometimes. And this is why sometimes I call it CD DJs, you know, because it's so easy for people to collect music nowadays where they can just, you know, download, you know, and they want to play the top 10.
Now, for real, even like these songs we have here now, yeah, these vinyl you have here now, they're very treasured because it's physical,
yeah,
and you have a connection with the actual vinyl. Like, oh, yo, you know, you might can remember where you bought most of these songs and these things, so you know it's not so disposable. Like this thing, even though I know the world has to move forward, I have to move on. So, like I said again, we're not complaining, but you know these songs have more value, I would say. I mean, for the whole fact of, you know, how you bought them, it's physical, it's you know, it's music and it's real and it's in your hand as well.
Yeah. Well, there's some DJs out there, they don't even know about vinyls. Now, as far as I'm concerned, when it comes to a DJ, you have to have done your apprenticeship. Now, if you know about vinyls, you've done your apprenticeship.
You know? Yeah, man, when I'm going to the studio, you know, and I want to see, you know, remember, reel to reel, you know.
Yes, exactly.
That's where I'm coming from, me. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I mean, we know the full length of the thing, and you know, 45 and all these things.
Okay, I'm going to introduce this next one here. It's one of your, I do believe one of your, well, I wouldn't even say your latest one, because sometimes when you go in the studios, you know, you could be in there like this week, and then, you know, a tune what you sang and released all 2-3 years later, yeah, am I correct?
Yeah, I've got a tune, funny enough, called Flame. You might not play it soon. And that song, I wrote that song 5 years ago.
5 years ago?
5 years ago, I wrote the song. And I knew the song was special. Yeah, but the song didn't really
it didn't fit on the EP that I released 5 years ago. So we put out an EP called Better Than Love. Yeah, which is like a rocksteady EP with original songs, all original songs. But Flame Against the Wind kind of had a different feel. So we held back the song. But the song is special, and I'm not a man to really, you know, shout about my music, my band, and say, yo, this song you're bad. I really love other artists. I'm always someone to love other artists, but you see Flame Against the Window? Song terrible, man. Song is a terrible song that people would really love, and I want to get it to more listeners. I want to get the song out there to more ears, because I feel like these songs need the attention, you know, like, you know, the songwriting for me on this song here is really, really top notch. You know what I mean? Top notch. And it's a personal song to me, and produced by Damon Marley again. Flame Against the Wind, you know?
Yeah, okay.
So I don't know if you have that one there.
Yeah, I've got that, but I'm not ready to play that one.
All right, don't say that.
We're going at it.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to play this one here. So if you can give us some info on this one, when you actually sang this one.
Said it's too late. Said it's too late. Too late. Said it's too late. Falling in. Said it's too late.
Are your turn now? You're a Chris.
It's too late to test my sound. Cause I believe we're going to kill you with the dogs.
Chop. Don't play live on the air in a studio.
Yeah,
once,
Chris.
Said it's too late, oh mate. Said it's too late. Yeah. That one. I said, look, this dub cost £1,000. Studio One will kill you with 1,000 rounds. We're going to tear the stage show down. Winston, he wears the crown. I sing, too late to test my sound. I believe we're going to kill you with dubs. It's too late to test my sound. Studio One is going to kill you with dubs. It's too late. Try test my sound. It's too late. Try test.
Christopher Ellis speaking. Studio One.
Oh, I tell you.
Number one sound in the world.
Front line's going crazy, right?
Universe.
Midnight
Galaxy.
I tell you. We'll take that one down nice and easy.